My name is Ces Butner, and I am the president of Rotary Club of Oakland. And then also we ask all other participants to look at the Zoom meeting, press the Zoom meeting button up in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. And we will take right now, if you have any comments throughout the meeting or questions for the speaker, please use the chat button at the bottom of the screen for that as well. And now for the thought for the day, Rotarian Sean Marks, your own.
I'm past president Sean Marks, and I'm coming to you from the Gulf of Florida, actually just back from the Gulf of Florida, and celebrating today 3 years with the beautiful Renia Webb, anniversary of our first date. So I thought it would be entirely fitting to share my favorite Stephen Covey quote about love. Love is a verb. Love, the feeling, is the fruit of love, the verb. Live, love, laugh, leave a legacy. Thank you, Ces.
Very, very, very good. That might deserve a bell ringer or something, Sean. You might want to try. I'll ring the bell for Sean for that beautiful thought for the day.
Thank you, Ces. And Renia.
Because we want to remain grounded and focused, we begin our meetings by reciting our vision, which is, together we see a world where people unite and take action to create lasting change across the globe, in our communities, and in ourselves. Last week, our membership committee chair, Jillian Lowe, laid out a theme and goals for membership for the 2021 year that included 50 new members, which we had an opportunity to discuss through in the breakout room. I'd like to thank all that participated in that effort. And I'd like to remind you that the job of membership rests with all of us. Everyone has a friend. I ask that you bring a friend to Rotary and let them share this gift of giving to the community. Please text, email Jillian, your friend or potential Rotarian, and we'll take it from there. Now I'd like to show you a video that is the first in a series of recruitment tools that Jillian developed to help us recruit new members. Sandeepa, can you run that for us?
Hi, President Ces. Thank you for taking the time today to answer a couple questions for me about Oakland Rotary.
My pleasure.
So why did you join Oakland Rotary number 3, and how long have you been a member?
Well, I've been a member since 1995, about 25 years. And I joined initially for the Camp Enterprise program that we have. Enterprise Institute. It's a program where we take 60 high school juniors from all across Oakland to a camp in Santa Cruz Mountains and teach them how to be business owners. It's a wonderful opportunity for us to really give back to the youth of Oakland and teach them about our business principles.
What are the 3 things that keep you engaged besides being the president, obviously?
Well, being president takes a lot of time for me right now. But our World Community Service, which is our international effort, our community service, which is our local effort, and then, of course, the people. The people of Oakland Rotary are the best. Those are 300 of my new best friends, as we always say to new members when they come in. We give them a roster and say, now meet 300 of your newest best friends.
So why should I visit and see what Oakland Rotary number 3 is all about?
They asked me that. I think the reason why is because you'll get the gift of giving. I think it's, our logo says Rotary opens opportunities for service above self. And it is the number one thing that you will get satisfaction that you will get from being an Oakland Rotarian. Service above self.
Great. Thank you. And we invite all of you to come check Oakland Rotary number 3 out at a Thursday meeting virtually at 12:30.
Be there.
Ah, that's great. Jillian will release soon and may come to ask other Rotarians to video, why did you join Rotary? She'll ask you to do another one and she'll put out a series of all of those. This week, we're going to give Community Service Committee a chance to do the same thing. After a brief explanation from Chairperson David Kittner on his direction of the year, you'll have an opportunity to do it in breakout rooms to give him feedback and help. So let's get started with the meeting. First, former District Governor Ed Yellen, do we have any visiting Rotarians?
Hello, President Ces. We don't have any visiting Rotarians that checked in. Although we do have a guest, if I may introduce Allison Bliss's guest, we're happy to have with us today Regina Evans, who some of you may remember came to our club and presented a poem on human trafficking from her play, 52 Letters. So nice to have Regina with us here today, and thank you, Allison, for inviting her. Well, that's what I have, Ces.
Thank you, Ann. We always welcome all of our guests and our Rotarians when they do come. We are inducting two new members today. Each will be introduced by their sponsor with two interesting facts about our newest Rotarians. We will begin with Rotarian Ruth Throop. Ruth.
Hello, everyone. It is my great pleasure to introduce Tommy Edwards to you. I know Tommy from many years in financial services. He's currently Vice President and Client and Treasury Manager at Beneficial State Bank, just up the street from our regular meeting spot. Tommy and I share a great love of cooking, music, including opera and jazz. He's a great traveler, and if you need a golf buddy, he's always happy to pick up that extra fourth spot. Couple of fun facts about Tommy. Recently, he traveled to London to see a Premier League soccer annual. He goes every year. He's a big sports fan. And then Tommy is very community oriented. He serves on four boards, including Junior Achievement, Berkeley Playhouse, Lotus Blossom, and the Sacramento Theater Company. Get to know our new friend and member, Tommy Edwards.
Thank you. And now to introduce the newest new member, a Rotarian, John Clausen.
Oh, yes, John Clausen. I'd like to introduce actually my wife, Pam Clausen, as a new member. Two interesting things about her. Pam was with KPMG for 22 years, 11 years as a partner. And then Pam became the CFO of American Baptist Homes of the West and continued as CFO through mergers and then name branding to the organization called Human Good, where she has now been CFO for 20 years.
Thank you.
That's Pam.
Thank you. Tommy and Pam, we are happy to have you chosen. You have chosen to join us, and please know that your family and friends are always welcome to join us to participate in our projects and events.
Thank you for the welcome.
By accepting membership, you have adopted our vision. Together we see a world where people unite and take action to create lasting change across the globe, in our communities, and in ourselves. You also agree to conduct your affairs according to the Rotary four-way test. Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships, and will be beneficial to all concerned? You will receive your Rotary pin, the way it up on the screen, and we hope you will wear it with pride and find pleasure and fulfillment by attending meetings, participating in our service activities, and practicing service above self, and by contributing to the Rotary Foundation and Oakland Rotary Endowment. You'll also receive via mail the roster, Rotary with 300 of your newest best friends, Rotary Made Easy Handbook, your four-way test, and our centennial book, which documents 100 years of service and friendship in the third oldest club in the Rotary world, Oakland number 3. Finally, when we return to live meeting, your badge will be waiting, indicating your status as a new member. And so now it is my pleasure and honor to induct you as newest members of the Rotary Club of Oakland. Let's give our newest members a warm Rotary welcome. It doesn't come out as loud as it does in the in-person meetings, but we're working on that. I'll get a soundtrack to come forward. But we welcome you nonetheless. Thank you. As I said earlier, our community service chair, David Kittner, is here to tell us his committee, about his committee, and we'll accomplish his goals this year with your help, I guess. The floor is yours, David.
Thank you very much, President Ces. I am David Kittner, and I'm the current chair of the Community Service Committee. And for those of you who do not know, Community Service has got three main tasks. Oakland Rotary distributes grants every year, and Community Service is tasked with doing the due diligence on the grant requests that we receive. Community Service conducts the Feed the Hungry food drive every year, which has been going on for well over 30 years. And just recently, we've been asked to start conducting some additional service days for the club. So let me unpack those just a little bit. Last year, Rotary received 17 separate grant requests that the committee did due diligence on, and that means that you are calling the applicant. If possible, you go to the site, see what they're doing, get engaged with it, and then present your findings to the committee as a whole. So it's something that you're very tangibly involved, hands-on, getting involved with our local nonprofit organizations. And so last year we had 17 grant requests. We approved nine for $32,550, all supporting our local community. The second thing that we do is we've been conducting a Feed the Hungry food drive for over 30 years. For many, many years, Sean Marks graciously matched what we raised. And last year, he's not with his company anymore. So we raised on our own, I'm very proud of, $15,000 at lunch where we raise money. It's the only time that we raise money at the lunch meeting. And we give that money to nine different local charities. This year, we've already got the date set, December 3rd. We've got our speaker, celebrity chef, Nikki Shaw. So hopefully we'll come close to what we raised last year. And finally, service days. We have been asked, and this is where we're looking for some help in the breakout. We've been asked to do some service days, service projects that are one-off. One-off meaning that you don't have to join a committee. You don't have to do any legwork beforehand. You just go show up and you go do a service day. And in the past, we've been able to do activities such as the Alameda County Food Bank. We've done quite a few days where we've done fire prevention work up at the Police Activity League camp. And we've also been judges for the Urban Debate League, among others. So with COVID changing how many organizations are as the food bank, they have it is very different than the way it used to be. We're looking for ideas of service days that we can continue to accomplish given the restrictions that COVID have. So we would like to get some ideas of what we could possibly do. Again, we're not trying to create another committee. We're not trying to get something big started, but what can we do to provide people with just a very quick one-off opportunity while things are going forward? And if it dovetails with homeless, so much the better. And so that's what we're doing.
Thank you, David. That's a good description. And now we're going to go to the breakout rooms, where in addition to general fellowship, I'd like for you to discuss the ways that you can help David find unique ways to do service projects in this COVID-19 pandemic year. Have someone in your room take on the job of scribe to write a list of your suggestions and the group comes up with, and email, text, or that list to David, Pat, or me, and we'll take it from there. Jack, will you put us in the breakout room for about 5 to 8 minutes and give us a 1-minute warning before you bring us back? Thank you.
I cannot do both the breakout room and the music. You're muted.
You hear me? Two things. Yeah. It started out okay. Make sure you had the, you were okay. So make sure you have
the. It doesn't appear that we can do both of them together on Zoom.
Just try this.
I'm just going to leave it on like this.
Just.
I can't hear you.
Tell me what's really going on. I'm not hearing anything.
Yeah, people are coming back from the break room.
I got you. Okay. Hey there. Hey, good job. Good job.
You're welcome to play a little bit while people are coming in.
That's the way to riff.
It sounded like he was about to play Let's Get Down. I thought it was going to be
like
a quick Harold, in a second.
Harold, I was about to come start. On, man. Come on.
Harold, shut up so he can play.
Come on, let's get down, let's get down, let's get down. Come on, let's get down, let's get down. The function's on. Oh, hold on. I have to do this because it's an anniversary celebration, I believe, right?
Oh, yeah, it's your anniversary. I like it.
Renia, that is beautiful. Man, I've been on that girl since she was a kid. This is really, this is special.
Yeah, we're excited about our speaker that's going to be coming up soon. And I just want to say one thing from the breakout room. If you had any ideas, make sure you get them to David, email or text them to him, or you can put it in the chat communication. And finally, Pat Williams informed me that she did send out that yearly committee sign up form to us last week, and I think she might have sent a follow up for it. Please choose your committee and return it to Pat so you can do your service of yourself. Now I'm excited about our speaker today, who I understand may be coming a member as well. Might become.
Love to have you, Dwayne.
Rotarian and World Community Service Co-Chair, Renia Webb, do us the honor of introducing our speaker.
Awesome. Greetings, fellow Rotarians and guests. It is my honor and privilege to introduce our guest speaker today. Our families go back generations, even before he and I were thought of. We come from families rooted in a rich legacy of giving back through ministry and through community service. Dwayne is an Oakland native, a civil rights and social justice leader, an accomplished musician, artist, composer, and producer. He's a founding member of Tony, 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 and he's made his mark in the music industry working with some of the greats, which includes Queen Bee, Beyonce, having really helped discover and root and shape them while working with Destiny's Child. Dwayne lives a life of service, continuing to give back this day through his nonprofit organization, which supports youth through music and tech. He's a constant champion of grassroots organizing, and he globally shares his message of love and hope still through his music. He's recently been inducted to the Songwriters Hall of Fame, and I'm just honored and excited to hear what he's up to today. So without further ado, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Dwayne Wiggins.
Oh, Renia, that is so special, first of all, because, I mean, like, right, just watching you grow up and, man, I don't know what to say because it was like, I didn't know I was all those things you just mentioned. I just, you know what I mean? I learned I had beautiful people to draw my passion and the arts, and Oakland was just the breeding ground of champions. Renia, your dad did a lot for me. He was one of the ones at a time when the Tony started that just gave me some insight to understand, hey, you're going to be on that stage, but you better understand what's going on behind the stage. You know, that man he hooked up the B3 that we keep to this day right now, but you know, I got to get it back from my buddy. Let me get back to it. Listen, I am from West Oakland, born and raised. I'm an Oakland native, and it's a beautiful thing. My parents are from the South, Pine Bluff, Arkansas, and Texas. So I grew up in Oakland when they migrated. Of course, everybody came from the South through that train station in West Oakland. So I look, you know, I passed your location over there off of Wood Street many, 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 many times. And West Oakland for me at that time was, wow, it was, community was family. I just remember everything was at your access. It was just, West Oakland was like the world, you know what I mean? I only had a little red wagon, but I was rich with things that were in the neighborhood. Everybody had their gardens. Everybody had their own businesses. Everybody supported each other, you know. Schooling and education was big, but socializing together and learning how to build was everything. We policed ourselves. How about that? Let's talk about that one. Because in my lifetime, you know, I grew up across the street from Defermery Park, so I got this knot on my head right here, so I'll never take it off. It's a lot of history, and I used to watch the Black Panthers rehearse. I used to watch, the Black Panthers give their, I don't want to say that they were more or less, you know, always just connected with the community. I didn't know how big it was because it was just people we knew. And you see Sly Stone over there jamming at the park, and then them speaking and them feeding, and they also gave me the opportunity to rehearse in one of their places, and I found out much later on in life that they owned that spot. But they were the type of people, you know, they let you rehearse, and if you were doing something foul, they check you. They didn't call your parents. So the community raised us, really. You know, if you did something in school on your way home, you know, the neighbors would check you before you even got home. Your mom never had to worry about coming home if you did your homework or not. When I moved to East Oakland, believe this or not, this was moving on up. I moved to Sovrani Park. Woo! Let me tell you, that change right there meant so much because it's when I first got my hands on a guitar. My father was a blues guitarist. He used to take me to the blues spots, and they used to rehearse in the kitchen and everything. So, you know, when I learned how to play this guitar, I played in for a talent show, I remember, right across the street from where my warehouse is, where I have my nonprofit, Tassa Faranga. My first talent show, and that's where I learned losing is winning, because I lost. I was playing some Jimi Hendrix, you know, and that's what happened. But I've always looked at, you know, like you said, adversities, those opportunities in most places, especially when you come from our type of neighborhood. So this guitar has always been my shield, and I tell you, it has distracted me from all the crazy adversities that were going down in Oakland, because I know I would have fell victim to it just as well as many of my friends that are not around, that spirit is carried to this day. So I'm really passionate about this, and, you know, I'm always connected with the next generation. That's how I got the opportunity to produce a group like Destiny's Child and sign them and move them from Houston, Texas to Oakland, and giving them what I call TSM, Tony's Schooling of Music, which is the business, the game. I can remember sitting... going through the record companies, they always funded things great. So I was able to, since they were underage, most of the groups I signed, every group I signed was over 18. And under 18, I learned business at a whole nother level. So taking the, you know, the songs that I grew up with, you know, the "If You Want Me to Stay, I'll Be Around Today to Be Available for You to See." You'll see that type of stuff on this video montage where the girl, they call her today, her name is Gabby, had the honor of grooming them. And those were the songs that I pulled from to show them what, you know, passing the gift was about. And you'll hear their rendition of it. And it's just a blessing. Plus, you'll see some things in coding. The police issue I had, there's a youngster that did an app called Cop Stop. And now I'm learning from the next generation. You guys, check this out. It's just a little insight on what I do.
Skills to work with the rest of the world, so. What is Youth Aid? Youth Aid is a spaceship for the next generation. I have to put it like that. All of this right now is icing on the cake, because as I let you know before it started in 95 when I signed Destiny's Child with Beyonce and all the rest of the whole crew, and I learned how to develop young artists, and that was like, you know, the last album of Tony Honey Tony, and I was going into this. So since then, you know, I was always working with the next generation of people, Alicia Keys, Keisha Cole. That's what Youth Aid is. So music, tech, and health. Youth Aid takes place in East Oakland at this point, but it has.
Yes, you do. Yeah. I got that check. I love it. Anyway, take it far away. You're sure to find your destiny.
Kick it!
And you know without a doubt that I would be your.
Kick it!
Some of the unexpected hurdles is that you think that having a nonprofit is just, you get a lot of money and people donate it, this, that, and the other. Everybody will say, I'm starting a nonprofit. And I remember Jerry Brown used to always ask me if I had a nonprofit. He was my backwards ass way of thinking. Look, and I had the studio in West Oakland, and this is what he was campaigning to be mayor. What I found out is you have to really be organized to have a nonprofit. You know, it's all about the matter of factuals. What are you supporting? What are you getting back to? And let's see who's really benefiting from this.
How did music change your life?
Wow. First of all, this yeah. thing right here, this guitar here is like my savior, like my shield. But if it wasn't for my parents sticking behind me and the community sticking behind me, this guitar distracted me from a lot of things that would have had me using a whole entirely different weapon. You know, I was able to see the world because of this guitar, and it changed my life. And that's why I'm just, I'm passionate about giving back. We have what we call Tony School of Music, and the younger generation really has to understand what it takes to do this industry, the business of it.
Let's go right here. One, two, and.
And I see this energy, and I see this new generation all into the tech and the creative and working together. I'm like, oh, I'm excited because I know that the hood breeds champions. Keeping them off the street, they're pretty excited about this. And we'll go on the green screen stage and they'll see themselves with a song idea just come to life right before their eyes.
When people think about the tech economy, they think about white men, but they don't think about me. And when you take the people who are from this area, who oftentimes don't have backgrounds in technology or in engineering, there is a fear that they might be left behind. The way I meet these young people is through the workshops that I host, through the hackathons that I organize. So when they see me, that in itself is an invitation. It's an invitation for women, and it's an invitation for people of color, because now they know they have people like them on the inside who can help them, who can guide them, who can support them.
I was intimidated by me thinking that I wasn't good enough. But me having that experience to think that has reshaped my whole mind frame. I know that I'm good enough. I know that I'm beyond good.
Tell me the problem that you're trying to solve in this world. Tell me how you're trying to make it go away.
One of my ideas was picked up, and I created an application called CopStop. And CopStop is going to be the 21st century key from staying safe from police brutality. It's created to help eliminate the feelings of danger, anxiety, and inequality brought on when interacting with law enforcement. I've always wanted to make my mark on the world, so me having technology and being so passionate about it, I think this is my key.
You probably heard that song before. Now one of the men behind the music is turning his passion into a way to help others. Dwayne Wiggins is a member of the group Tony, Tony, Tony. He was raised in Oakland, and now he's back running a nonprofit organization.
They're making music for the next generation. And their mentor is an Oakland native who's been where they want to be.
Let's just go from the pool. What's up, California? Such, and bring it in from there.
Dwayne Wiggins, best known as part of Tony, Tony, Tony. Says it feels good to make a difference, and he's doing just that with his nonprofit.
So in terms of being effective in the world, you got to really be effective within your community before you can reach out. So it means a lot to me to come back. This is where I played my first talent show, and I lost.
And now, nearly three decades later, he's giving back to the community that raised him. Right across the street, basically, right there from where it all started, yes, is your new beginning.
It's my new beginning. It's called Mind Seed, and we're definitely planting some seeds in minds these days, especially with the youth, and we are right in the heart of it right now.
Youth Aid is housed in Mind Seed Soundstage in East Oakland, inside a green room, two rehearsal spaces, a recording studio, and a collection of Tony, Tony, Tony memorabilia.
That green kind of is not coming off right there.
You know what? Look, it feels good. The children have access to all of the things inside the soundstage, and the cost, get this, is nothing. Now, this is a 6,000 square foot soundstage where students learn every aspect of the music business, from learning how to sing to writing a contract. That way, they're set up for success in the future.
If I didn't have music in my life, I'd probably be sitting at home.
That is such the truth. That what she said right there, you know. We just had platforms back in the day that gave us opportunity to learn. We didn't know that you were being groomed, but you know, to be in a talent show back then, you had to come and show up at rehearsals on time, and it went for months before they gave productions. They gave productions at the Oakland Auditorium that sold out with, you know, talent shows. So I've always believed in giving back to the community that developed me, and now I'm learning from the next generation. This tech thing.
Be able to play in this space, and Dwayne gives us this opportunity.
It would be a sin for any of us in my group, the Tonys, graduating from Castle Mountain, growing up Serenity Park, West Oakland, whatever, and not pass this information down.
Over the summer, the students took part in Youth AIDS Camp, where they made this PSA about California's drought. Turn off the water when you brush your feet. Wash your car quickly when you're off the street.
They learned how to write scripts, type stuff, you know, write this, you know, make sure these lyrics say something, you have fun with it, but say something. But they ended up going in there and putting it together and producing a PSA.
Wow, that was in Brookfield too. You know what I mean? To see them start talking about something, having fun about the drought, and all of a sudden, I say, we're going to write a PSA, public service announcement, and I'm going to make you guys look like TLC. This is what I'm talking about. So it's nothing greater, man, to
this mayor, because she's, you know, using her birthday to celebrate and get back. That's big.
Yeah, I sure did use that platform to make it happen.
Yeah, this gentleman will help out a lot with some stuff that's going on in production tonight, but he was a drum teacher for our 6-week summer camp, Tony School of Music. So
yes, sir.
Let him know about yourself,
man. I'm Jeremiah Cobbs. I taught Dwayne summer camp. Tony Summer Music,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I had a blast. I was honored to teach one of the drummers for the Sisters Keeper band, Dilia. Great worker. Just amazing.
You say that's three productions, and the reason I say that is because even my summer camp, kids are coming in for the education part, but I'm giving the production. I'm like, I'm about to.
That's the art and soul. I mean, Oakland was known for giving some of the dopest festivals. That's why I started A Taste of Oakland. But you got to know how to perform. You got to know how to entertain, not just play an instrument and sing. Zendaya. Hey, the drummer was 12 years old. Do you understand? Every kid on that stage went to Oakland School of the Arts, and I used to bring them down to LA. This is what I produce at my sound stage.
Has come for us to make a change in our lives. No time for tears, it has to come from you and me. Together we'll find unity, this I know.
Just a little something from the from deep East Oakland.
Hi.
So, you know, what we were making happen right here is I took some of the summer nonprofit summer camps, and we just did something together. There's a soccer camp back there called We United, and it started in West Oakland years ago, maybe 10 years ago. And then there's another camp of young ladies, and this was the group called Sisters Keeper. And they were part of my first summer, Tony School of Music summer camp, the 6-week summer camp thing. And it was funny because all the time the kids were like, we're doing music in the whole bit. But I aligned myself with a tech company. And I was able to show them that there's so many platforms out there that this music can be attached to, not just records anymore, because the industry has definitely changed. So Sisters Keeper at one point was putting together a concept of an app that empowered young women. And that's what it's about, you know, just building. Even the facility that I'm in, it was owned by a gentleman by the name of Ed Anderson. And in the late 70s, and I want to say like 79, he created the music to Miss Pac-Man. And so now I got kids creating music for some of the games that are being created with some of these tech companies here in Oakland. And really and truly, I'm the student. I'm just the janitor that cleans up behind them. But I know, you know, after working with Destiny's Child, I recognize after 13, hey, we may as well as parents recognize that we're educating. We can only teach morals and being and being passionate about whatever your endeavor is. And so it's exposure. Exposure is key. As I've been doing this in Oakland so long, I'm looking forward to taking what we do worldwide now into Ghana and other places. I really appreciate the time and getting to know what Rotary is all about. And because I've never got, you know, this close, and I've been around, and you guys were hosting a lot of things at the California Ballroom. Oh, do I have memories in that location. So that means a lot to me. And I want to say, you know, as I see a lot of the faces I recognize, Renia, beautiful. Hey, I'm saying, Ces, let me just say this, my man. You are a role model to a lot of people you probably will never even understand. Or know, but just I'm letting you know from a street level to all the way around. You know, I witnessed a lot of things in Oakland. And that's why I walk around the world. I feel like I can do whatever you want to do. Just stay focused. You don't count nobody else's money because you're the money. Take care of yourself.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Sir. Thank you, Dwayne.
I appreciate it.
Wonderful everything. Presentation today.
Yes, sir.
Jack, do we have questions for our speaker here? Will you answer some questions for us, Dwayne?
Yeah, I'm an Aquarius. Let's go. All over the place. Let's go.
Jack or Sandeep, which one? Who's recording the chat room?
I've got the questions today, Ces. Dwayne, thank you so much for joining us. We really do appreciate it. Anyone who has a question for Dwayne, please put it in the chat. But Allison did ask, how old are the amazing kids in Sisters Keeper?
Oh, the youngest was 12 years old, actually. You know, but in my summer camp, we started from 8 to 18. But the youngest was like 12 years old. And it's really strange because the drummer that was for Zendaya was 12 years old. And I used to feel bad for him because the drummer can't stop. You know, the guitar player, we can do our thing and stop. The drummer has to keep going. And he was in charge of everything. So that let me know that, you know, kids have to be given responsibilities at a much earlier age today. You know, traveling outside, and when I was in Accra and a whole bit, I saw families having business, you know, and kids 8 and 9 years old taking the fabric that I brought and measuring it out for them to, you know, do an outfit for the Tonys or something. So I'm saying, put them in early. That's what I learned. Yes.
Excellent. And then Allison also wants to know if you play with the orchestra as well, or in orchestra.
Have I? Would I? What? Come on! Yeah, I'm looking forward to the young gentleman, the awesome orchestra. We talk some good game, and there's some things that me and my brother Raphael have done that never touched the surface. And I think that, and first of all, I mean, we've done it years ago, but we don't look at our music like it's, you know, about what's now. It's music that's timeless. And to us, because we write songs, we don't write tunes. We write songs that, you know, hopefully we can hear for the rest of our lives. Yes.
Nice. Yes, and then our club member, Alex Polson, wants to know if you attended the festival at the lake, which Oakland Rotary put on a while ago.
I wasn't at that one. I believe I was on the road on one of those days. But yeah, believe you me, my spirit was there. Yes, it was. I knew just about everybody on every stage, I'm sure. I love that, man. I love seeing musicians that I've had the opportunity, or they've had the opportunity, the spirits together and watch them excel. It's nothing like that. It's just like winning. When I see them win, I feel like I'm winning. That's a feeling of Oakland that people don't have anymore. So I don't get this new age of Oakland. But my thing is, when you see someone that you've had the pleasure of meeting and you share space and you see them winning, that's you winning. Mm-hmm. That's us. We.
I love it. And then Robert Abel, he wants to know, what could you use? What can the Rotary Club do to help you?
You know, if you've done quite a bit just now, seeing how it all works, the reality of it. I heard the young lady speaking about the human trafficking organization she supports. I have a movie that I've done in Ghana and in the Virgin Islands. And I've scored it, by the way, orchestra guys. Yep, I've scored it. And the movie is called Timeless. It's going to come out with Netflix and stuff. But you know, it's about human trafficking. It's a beautiful movie. The music is beautiful. But the sad story is about human trafficking. And I needed to enlighten our people.
Awesome. Let's see. And then Gary Flaxman wants to
G-Man. Where's your bike, bro?
He's asking you to tell us about Pop Life and what your boys are doing now.
Whoa. Pop Life was something that every one of those young people that you saw came through, so to speak. It happened. I started it long after Destiny's Child, but my kids were able to see, you know, Beyonce in the kitchen and this, that, and the other, and her having homeschooling and all that. So Pop Life was something I started where I wanted to have my family focused, and that brand was something that just stuck out. Of course, I'm a big Prince fan, and to know that he supports the tech industry, I'm a big Prince fan, and my kids had the opportunity to meet them. But right now they are in LA and taking the gift that they've learned in Oakland. I've used every stage as how to develop them. I mean, all of these times when Barbara Lee would give my kids the opportunity to come on stage, it's about how you make it to that stage, just the interviews, expressing who you are. I always told the kids that, hey, listen, you can do music all day. It just simply becomes the score to you. A superstar is someone when they like you. So you got to get to know your people. Yes. Go on. I'm sorry to go get long-winded. I'm probably taking our meeting long over. I suppose we have five minutes. But I just want to say.
Got a few more questions that we'll ask you.
Okay, great.
Go ahead, Jack.
So could you tell us about the House of Music Museum banner behind you? Lori Ailman is asking.
Whoa, House of Music. The story behind that, first of all, I was able to put a House of Music Museum in Jack London Square when I did the Taste of Oakland Festival, 3 days. And I gave them some raw Oakland, a little bit of everything on that stage, but at a major production. I was raised around Bill Graham's production, so I understand how to do production, and I'm really into it. Plus, I got this new thing going. But House of Music was the a record store that our last album was called House of Music, and we paid homage to that record store. That record store changed East Oakland community. Let me just tell you, you go in there and all the black light posts, the blue light posters in there and the patches and everything. And I bought one of my first 45s. You guys, I'm not talking about a gun. I'm talking about, listen, one of my first 45s and albums from there. And we learned so much in there. Sly Stone was a DJ. And the way he became popular is he used to, on the radio station, he'd mix some of his own stuff. So when I hear the songs like Hot Fun, Hot Fun in the Summertime and all that, oh my God, it makes me, gives me chills. House of Music is that. It's really a lot of history of Oakland. That's what House of Music is. And actually, okay, we ended up doing a virtual reality of that. It's a lot of memorabilia of Tony, Honey, Tony, the outfits, everything, how we were inspired by seeing Larry Graham in the, you know, grocery store with a big silver wig on and boots and a whole bit, and he's grocery shopping, and they come to your school, and you. So yes, House of Music is the Bay Area, 100%.
Nice. And then President Ces, time for one more.
Yes, one more.
Last one, topical. How have you been handling with COVID? What strategies have you been using to move forward with your young people and educating them and you know, rehearsing and recording?
Oh my God, we've been zooming. It's what I've been, and listen, look at me, I'm learning this, even this right here. Sandeep, I want to thank you because I've learned so much about how, you know, managing it, being a media situation, you know, that's big to me. The COVID situation has worked for me, let me just say, because I've been touring for 30 something years, believe it, and moving at a fast pace. Whoa, so just me being able to sit home for 3 or 4 months, okay, yeah, I have to look at it like I wasn't able to do my nonprofit 6-week summer camp and then my Taste of Oakland and our closing out situation, because those concerts were what fed those things within it. I didn't start my nonprofit till 2015 or 2013, but the point is that COVID has given me the opportunity to get organized and really look at, okay, how to come back and perfect what you've done and hit it on the head, because this has got to roll hard for the next 3, 5, 7 years. We got to change minds. The ship has got to turn. So yes, COVID has worked for me. Every blessing, I mean, every curse. So I'm just sorry. Adversity is spent. That's time to power up.
Very good. That's inspiring. That makes everybody know that whatever situation you're thrown, you make lemon out of lemon.
Yes, you take lemons and we make
lemon drops.
This Thursday. Say it again.
I have a comment. If you're looking for a tech person, I'm your girl.
Yes, I see. Oh my God. Like, I don't know where you are in the universe, but whoa. Hot, man. So, and you know what? I attribute this to the young generation for schooling me, because I understand. I'm not supposed to be understanding like this right now. I really get it. So I give them, you know, I pay respect. You know, we go into the studio, I'll say what I want to do, but I'll step out of the way. And so I'll say, how do I achieve my goal to these youngsters? And they'll go back and break it down to me like,
Are you gonna? Is Tony gonna make any music anymore?
Absolutely. And hopefully we can work with this the orchestra and get some beautiful strings on top of it. Our music, it would be classic. I want to do. You know what? Oakland has always changed the game, and I know you guys know that. You can go back from years. Grateful Dead, everybody, such. We've changed the industry. In Vogue, when they came, Too Short changed the industry. Come on, man, Hammer changed the industry. The Tonys, we changed the industry. It's time right now, and it's moving. Her has changed the industry.
Well, thank you so much, Tony. Tony.
Right on, Seth.
Really well.
Good brother.
Dwayne, this year, our club is making homeless crisis in Oakland a priority.
Yes.
To that end, and as a gift to you for being our speaker for the day, in your honor, we're making a donation to support our unhoused residents in Oakland.
Good brother, I appreciate it, yes.
We would like to give you our centennial book, which documents 100 years of service and friendship in the third oldest club in the Rotary world, Oakland number 3, written by our very own Rotarian, Linda Hamilton. We just really like to thank you for joining us for this Rotary meeting. This was special for me because I was always a big fan of Tony.
Right on, boy. Thank you very much. Well, we learned from you.
All right.
Appreciate it, good man.
Jack, do we have any bell ringers that we need to mention?
Let's see. We did have, I believe, 2 bell ringers. Yourself, President Ces, you rang the bell.
I rang the bell for Tony. And Dwayne Wiggins.
Winning.
And then we also had Joycey Mack, who wanted to ring the bell in honor of John Lewis today.
Oh, yes. That's a good one. Anybody else?
President Ces, what does a bell ring mean?
Ah, good. Glad you asked that. Bell ring is a $100 donation to the Oakland Rotary Endowment. We make that anytime anyone wants to recognize somebody for a special occasion or anything. That's what we were trying to do.
Bell ring. Awesome. And
if I may, there was one other bell ring. Joycey Mack rang the bell a second time, and this was in honor of Dwayne Wiggins.
All right.
Hey, Joycey.
And we have a few others. We have a few others coming in.
We'll go right in.
Okay, so Shonda Scott for Dwayne's induction into the Hall of Fame. And we also have Tom Love for Dwayne. And then we have Marie Savarmuthu for John Lewis.
Okay.
Ring the bell.
I rang it. You didn't hear it? Rotarian Winter Williams, will you tell us about next week's speaker?
Yes, thank you, President Ces. I am entering into chat the bio for Melissa Jones. She is the executive director of the Bay Area Regional Health Inequities Organization. They in their health departments to create health equity and economic opportunity for all through collective action. And this is, as you know, part of our speaker series as our club figures out how we are going to make a difference for unhoused brothers and sisters. I encourage, feel free to put in there a question that you might want to make sure she addresses on the topic of homelessness and mental health.
Very good.
Also, Dwayne, we need you to come join this club.
Okay.
You can be part of our music.
Oh, the music committee. Yeah, which one of them runs?
Here, here.
Every hero needs to sing.
All right.
Theme music. I'll follow you around.
All right. Thank you, Winder. Thank you, Sean, for the day. Thank you, David, for getting us in community service.
Of all of us. So please consider coming back. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, Renia, for introducing our fabulous guests, and thank you, Ruth and John, and welcome new members, Tommy Edwards and Pam Claus. I'd like to end this meeting as usual, and that's the way it was, or it went, on the 5,302nd club meeting of July 30th, 2020, Oakland Rotary number 3, third oldest Rotary club in the world. Everybody remember, Rotary opens opportunities for service above self. This meeting is a joke. Thank you.